Okay, this is a video explaining how to do the RevPASH exercise that we here compare the average duration of 25 minutes and then the average duration for meal of 20 minutes to see the difference, how the RevPASH is going to be affected and obviously what it means for us in a revenue growth percentage. So we have a restaurant with 180 seats, which is 36 tables and 5 seats each. Average check per person is 10 euros. We open 4 hours per day. The average duration per meal at the moment is 25 minutes. We will then reduce it by 5 minutes to 20 and see the effect. And we will elaborate on some actions that we can take. And normally we have around 4 guests per table. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to fill in the table here for the average duration with a meal of 25 minutes. So we want to find out what is the rotation per table first, meaning how many rotations can we serve in 1 hour. So we take 60 minutes for 1 hour divided by 25 minutes average meal time. So we know that in 1 hour of serving, we rotate the tables 2.4 times. So every table is occupied 2.4 times in that particular hour. That is for one table. Now we need to multiply this figure with 36 tables since we have 36 in our restaurant, not only one. And that gives us the average table rotation for 1 hour. Now, since we're operating 4 hours, we need to multiply this now with 4. To get the full hours of operation. So we now know that in our 4 hours operation, our tables rotate 345 times. Okay. Now we want to know how many seats that is occupied. So we take the table rotations and we multiply this with the average seat occupancy, which is 4. So we know that we are serving 1,382 guests. Number of seats available in our restaurant is the 180 seats multiplied by 4, because we have 4 operational hours. That's the total number of seats to be occupied. And therefore, we can now find out our seat occupancy percentage. So we take the number of seats occupied divided by the number of seats available for the whole operation. And that's 1.9. Now, how do we calculate our total revenue for the restaurant? Take the number of seats occupied or number of guests served, multiplied with the average check of 10 euros. And that's our revenue, 13,824. For this particular 4 hour operation. What does it mean for our RevPASH? Remember, you can calculate RevPASH 2 different ways. Either we take the total restaurant revenue divided by the total seats available, or we take our seat occupancy percentage multiplied with our average check of 10 euros. You see, same results. So we've done it correctly. Now we're doing exactly the same thing one more time. For the average duration of the meal only of 20 minutes, because we're going to try with our service procedures and kitchen procedures we will discuss afterwards to reduce the meal time by 5 minutes to see if we can serve more customers and they spend the same average amount and therefore we can increase revenue. So we're now going to calculate the same thing, 60 minutes divided by 20 minutes now, since we're losing 5 minutes of meal time. That's 3. Now we multiply this again with the number of tables in our restaurant, 36. And then we multiply this again with 4 hours of operation, right? Number of seats available is the same thing still because we haven't changed anything in our operational hours. Now we're going to calculate table rotations, multiply with the average occupancy per table, again with 4. And you can see now already an increase of number of guests or seats occupied. And now we can calculate our seat occupancy percentage. Yeah, increasing now to 2.4. What does it mean for our revenue restaurant revenue? Number of seats occupied, multiplied with 10 euros average check, 17,280. So already a revenue increase there. What does it mean for our RevPASH? Again, we can calculate total revenue divided by total seats available, 24 euros now. Or we can also calculate it again with the seat occupancy percentage multiplied with 10 euros. Same result. What's the difference in our RevPASH? Well, we take the current RevPASH, 24. Minus the initial one, 19.2. So we increase now by almost 5 euros, which is good. This is basically another starter or another dessert that we have sold now. Difference in revenue. Restaurant revenue minus the initial revenue. Oh, sorry. Restaurant revenue minus the initial revenue. So an increase of 3,456 euros. And that is a growth percentage of current result over previous. 25%, or if we do the comparison with the RevPASH, we can also do that, 4 euros 80 cents over 19.20, again, 25% increase, which is very good. Just by reducing the meal time 5 minutes, we have already increased almost €5 in RevPASH and almost 3,500 euros in revenue. Now, how can we take these actions? It seems that the restaurant is a very fast-paced restaurant. We're only opening for 4 hours, so probably like a small coffee shop / lunch break place for some people where they come with their colleagues for a quick lunch. So we probably could reduce the menu. We could only offer items that are quickly to be cooked or can be prepared in advance, salads, sandwiches, maybe only 3, 4, 5 hot main courses maximum that are easy to make. For example, a steak is a lot more difficult to cook on point than if we're talking about a chicken breast, things like that. So easy dishes in that regard. What else we can do? We can make the special lunch offer, maybe 10 euros for a main course and a drink, or a choice of dessert or choice of starter, something that is easy to eat and in a short amount of time. Or as well, what we could do is we can offer coffee and dessert then for takeaway, but it's a lot easier as well. So the guests don't stay longer in the restaurant to have coffee and tea afterwards or dessert. And then obviously later on as well, we can think about giving a weekly menu where people can obviously pre-order. So they just come and grab it. So we can serve even more people and they don't even occupy a seat.